Because I'm happy. I'm a Muslim, that's what makes me happy, and that's the truth.
Can we have the next question from a non-Muslim sister from this mic?
Assalamu alaikum, Dr. Nai. Actually, my non-Muslim friend, I'm asking this question on behalf of her. She attended your Universal Brotherhood Conference and she really respects you. She believes in one God, but she is born in a Hindu family. So she thinks that whom she calls Brahma is what we call Kali. So as long as he is following her religion, she should get salvation. Then how can we convince her that the only accepted religion to God is Islam? Thank you.
Sister posed a question. One of our Hindu friends had come for my talk in Shah Alam, Universal Brotherhood, and she liked the lecture, but she said that who she considers Brahma as God is same as Khalik, so can she go to Jannah? If you read the Hindu scriptures, if you read Rig Veda, book number 2, hymn number 1, verse number 3, one of the attributes given to God is Brahma. Brahma is called as the creator God. We Muslims have got no objection if someone says Almighty God is creator. If you translate creator into Arabic, it becomes Khalik. So we Muslims have got no objection if someone says Almighty God is creator or Khalik or Brahma. But if someone says Brahma is Almighty God who has got four heads and on each head is a crown, we Muslims take strong objection to it because you're going against Sweta Sitara Upanishad. Chapter number 4, verse number 19, which says, Na chasya pratima asti. Of that God there is no pratima. Pratima in Sanskrit means an image, a photograph, a painting, a picture, a portrait, a sculpture, a statue, an idol. So the Hindu scriptures as well as the Vedas, Yajurveda chapter 32, verse number 3 says, Na chasya pratima asti. Of that God there is no image, there is no photograph, there is no painting, there is no picture, there is no sculpture, there is no idol. So the moment you give an image to God, that means it is not the true God. And in the Hindu scriptures, I'd given a talk in Johor Bahru, Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in the world religious scriptures. In the Hindu scriptures, it prophesizes the coming of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. If you read Bhavishya Purana, Parva 3, Khanda 3, Adhyay 3, Shlokas 5 to 8, it talks about Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. If you read Bhavishya Purana, Parva 3, Khanda 3, Adhyay 3, Shlokas 10 to 27, it talks about Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. If it's Bhavishya Purana, Parva 3, Khanda 1, Adhyay 3, Shlokas 21 to 23, it talks about Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. If you read the Kuntab Suktas, Atharva Ved, book number 20, hymn number 127, verse number 1 to 14, it talks about Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. I can give references from Hindu scriptures. Atharva Ved, book number 20, hymn number 21, verse number 6. Atharva Ved, book number 20, hymn number 21, verse number 7, it talks about Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is called as the one who praises Ahmad in several places. In Yajurveda chapter 31, verse number 18. In Rig Veda, book number 8, hymn number 6, verse number 10. In Atharva Veda, book number 8, hymn number 5, verse number 16. In Atharva Veda, book number 20, hymn number 126, verse number 14. He is called as Nara Shansa. Nar means man, Shansa means praises, one who praises. If you translate Nara Shansa into Arabic, it becomes Muhammad. He is named as Muhammad Narashansa in several places in Hindu scriptures. In Rig Veda, book number 1, hymn number 13, verse number 3. In Rig Veda, book number 1, hymn number 18, verse number 9. In Rig Veda, book number 1, hymn number 106, verse number 4. Rig Veda, book number 1, hymn number 142, verse number 3. Rig Veda, book number 2, hymn number 3, verse number 2. Rig Veda, book number 5, hymn number 5, verse number 2. Rig Veda, book number 7, hymn number 2, verse number 2. Rig Veda, book number 10, hymn number 100, verse number 3. Yajurveda, chapter number 20, verse number 37. Yajurveda, chapter number 20, verse 57. Yajurveda, chapter number 21, verse number 31. Yajurveda, chapter number 28, verse number 2. Yajurveda, chapter number 28, verse number 19. Yajurveda, chapter number 28, verse number 42. I can go on and giving references only of Hindu scriptures about the last and final messenger Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. He is even prophesied as Kalki Avatar. If you read Kalki Purana, chapter number 2, verse number 5, 7, 11, 15, it says that the last and final messenger, his father's name shall be Vishnu Yas, that is servant of God, Abdullah, which was the name of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's father. His mother's name will be Sumati, which means peace, serenity. In Arabic, Amina, which was the name of the mother of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He'll be born in the village of Sambala, that is the village of peace and serenity, Makkah. He'll be born in the family of the chief of village of Sambala. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was born in the family of Quraysh. It says he'll be born on 12th day of Madhav, 12th Rabbi Awal. He will have four friends, the first for Khulafa Rashidin. There are so many prophecies. So if she's a good Hindu, she should believe in one God who has got no idol and no image. You should believe in the last and final messenger, the Kalki Avatar Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Hope that answers the question.
Thank you.
Let me tell you about my happiness. I get my happiness from Islam. It makes me kind and a better human.